The optic neuritis treatment trial was conducted to determine whether steroids improve the outcome of acute optic neuritis, whether treatment speeds the visual recovery, third, whether the risk-benefit ratio was favorable to treat with steroids, and finally, whether there was a long-term relationship between optic neuritis and multiple sclerosis. The ONTT was a multi-center randomized clinical trial conducted across 15 centers in the United States from 1988 to 1991. The persons included in the study were those aged 18 to 45 years that presented with an acute unilateral optic neuritis for the first time in the involved eye, and whose visual symptoms were of less than 8 days duration. There should have been no systemic disease other than multiple sclerosis and no previous treatment with corticosteroids for either optic neuritis or multiple sclerosis. All eligible persons were randomized to three groups: the prednisone group, the intravenous group, and the placebo group. The prednisone group was assigned to receive oral prednisone for 14 days, the intravenous group IV methyl prednisone for 3 days, followed by oral prednisone, and the placebo group received oral placebo for 14 days. All three groups received a short oral taper till day 18, prednisone for the first two groups and placebo for the third group. These were the demographics of the patients entered in the study. We shall study the results with respect to the original questions. Does treatment with steroids improve the outcome of acute optic neuritis? In all three groups, most patients had rapid visual recovery within 2 weeks of symptom onset. Improvement occurred up to 1 year, though many had complete recovery by 4 to 6 weeks. The only predictor of visual outcome at 6 months was severity of visual loss at the initial visit, regardless of the type of treatment instituted or lack thereof. With regard to speed of visual recovery between these two groups, it was faster in the intravenous group in the first 15 days. At 6 months, while the vision was similar in both groups, contrast sensitivity, color vision, and visual field were still better in the intravenous group. However, there was no difference at any time point between either rate of recovery or any visual function measures between the prednisone group and the placebo. With regard to the risk-benefit ratio, recurrences in either eye were 2 times more common in the prednisone group compared to either of the other two groups. If there was no probable or definite MS at baseline, subjects in the intravenous group had a definite lower rate of development of multiple sclerosis in the first 2 years. This benefit reduced for the next 3 years, and after 5 years, there was no benefit. The conclusions from this study were that both intravenous methyl prednisolone followed by oral prednisolone and no treatment were both viable options for persons with the clinical profile of the subjects in the study, whereas oral steroids alone in standard doses was not recommended because of the higher risk of recurrence. If you like this video, you may show your appreciation by making a small contribution to help support the channel. Here below the video window, click on Super Thanks. Choose the amount you would like to contribute and then click Buy and Send to complete the transaction. Thank you.